everyone, it's Karlee and welcome here back to my channel. This little setup here is reminding me so much of like a couple years ago when I first started YouTube. I would always like set my dresser this way. Anyway, so I thought I would come into my room and film a little sit down video for you guys just to share with you guys my 10 least loved, I don't know what the word is. I'm gonna have a title here. It's gonna be perfect and beautiful, but right now I don't know what I'm calling this video. I just kind of wanted to share some of the products that I really like don't think are worth the money. Not that they're like expensive by any means, but it's just like not really, I didn't see a use for it, or it didn't improve my overall life at all, and I just didn't enjoy using them. So I thought that this would be an interesting video for you guys to see. I did one of these, I believe last year in the summer, and it went really well and you guys seemed to really enjoy it. And I really love filming these as well because favorites videos are so like fun and you get great inspiration, but I think when you hear like what people dislike and will never purchase again or didn't even like finish up, I think that's very important too. So I wanted to show these products to you guys just in case you were thinking about picking it up, wanted to try it out. I don't know, there's so many things nowadays, it's hard to keep up, but with these things that I've tried, I couldn't even finish them, they were so bad. So I hope that you guys enjoy. If you do, please give the video a huge thumbs up. And if you guys haven't already, I would love for you to subscribe to my channel. If you're new and this is your first video on my channel, hi, hello, my name is Karlee. I make videos on here every single week on lifestyle, beauty, thrifted fashion, and just my everyday life. So if that's something you would enjoy, hit that subscribe button and let's hop in. Okay, so I tried to keep these things kind of in like the beauty category just because this is the stuff that I purchased the most of like skincare and beauty and hair stuff. I love trying all of that. It's one of my favorite things to do. So that's kind of what I tried to stick with. I'm gonna start with the makeup stuff. And the first thing that I have to share, which is actually kind of funny because it's what I'm wearing on my lips today. And the reason why I don't think that this is even like worth it is because the application is so difficult and so hard to achieve. So this is the ColourPop Ultra Blotted Lip in the shade Bit of Sunny, I believe. And yeah, it's just a nice ColourPop. You guys know I love ColourPop. I have multiple of their liquid lipsticks. I've never tried a red before from them, and I recently just lost my favorite red from Stila Cosmetics, and I thought I'd pick one up. And I wanted to try ColourPop because, like I said, I love all of their stuff, and definitely wanted a new red, and this is like so annoying. I want to love this so much. It makes me so mad. I love the shade, like the color is exactly what I want. And I think if you guys, like, I wish I had a mirror, but I think if you guys were to see me maybe like in person, you would kind of see that it's just very translucent in a weird way. Like, it doesn't hold on to my lips. Like, my lips don't hold on to it, and the color payoff is really bad. It blots all around. I can't get it to like be very red and like there in your face, and that's what I want when I wear red lips. So yeah, I wear it because it's my only red lip, and when I want a red lip, I'm gonna do all that I can. But I promise you there are better on the market. I will list some of my favorite down below. All of these things, I will list some of my favorites of these things down below in the description box. If you ever wanna check out what I'm loving, it's always down there. Yeah, not a fan. The next thing is an eyeliner, and this is NYX Professional Makeup. That's the point. It's just their nice little fine point eyeliner, and I thought that I was going to love this because I usually like doing my eyeliner like I did today with like a gel pot liner and a brush. But on those days where it's like, I don't know, you're kind of busy or you're going on a trip, it's nice to just have one like applicator and just pop it on and you're done. So I thought that I would give this a try, and I loved how easy it was to apply. I will say, like, the first couple uses I really thought I was gonna love it, and then throughout the day it kind of like transfers onto my lid no matter how much I like prep my eyelids. It also like just sort of fades like in the crease areas like closer to my eye. I don't even know what I'm trying to point to, but like right here it kind of like creases and just like fades out of nowhere, and it's not like the blackest black that I've used. So for that I just didn't really love it. It's not like an expensive price point, which is nice, but yeah, it's not my favorite. But I'm still on the hunt for like an applicator like this because I, like I said, I just think it's so easy for the summer just to pop on a quick liner, like for a dinner night or something like that. I don't know, I think it would be really fun. So yeah, I'm on the hunt for one, but this one was definitely not my favorite, just due to like the color payoff was really bad. And for some reason I'm being super snooty about color payoff, which I didn't think I was, but it needs to be there and it needs to be prominent for me to love it. So moving on. The next thing is the e.l.f. Poreless Putty Primer, and I'd heard about this with, I was shopping with my mom and we both picked up one of these. I heard it's supposed to be a dupe for something. I can't think of what the dupe is it's for, but I've also seen it a ton on TikTok. Everybody loves it, and I don't know if it's like my certain moisturizers or maybe like my powder foundation or whatever I'm using, but it isn't great. I always put it on and then throughout the day I can see that it's like crumbling up on my skin, so I tried a different moisturizer, it still did it. I tried like liquid foundation to powder or powder to liquid, and I just couldn't get it to work. So I'm so bummed, and I want to know if I'm doing it wrong, but I honestly like barely even like scraped the top. I just couldn't do it. I noticed immediately that it was just like making my makeup transfer and ball up, so I don't know what I was doing wrong or if there's a better one out there. I don't really use primers anyway, so maybe that's why I'm not the biggest fan. They're just not in my routine currently, so I don't know. I'm not gonna miss this, but I was bummed that it didn't work out for me. Okay, moving right along to face products. These are the things that I definitely try the most, but also the category that I stay like most stuck in, if that makes sense. Like when you find a good skincare, it's so hard to branch out. So I've been trying to add new things, and I have some really great products that I've been loving and I can't wait to share with you guys. But the things that I hated and didn't love are up next. So this one is the Versed Just Breathe Clarifying Serum, and I decided to put this in here. If you guys have been watching me for a while, you know that this has been a feature in some of my favorites, in some of my skincare routines, so it's kind of funny that I'm adding it to here. But the only reason I am is because I didn't end up finishing this one up. I think I finished one up before, but I have just like an extra bottle here that I never go to because I found something better, and that's kind of the reason why I'm putting it in here. Versed is a great brand. It's at Target and I love it. I love trying all of their things, but when it comes to my serums, I want them to really like do something for my skin, and with this one I just didn't see anything happening, good or bad, which was a great thing. Like when I first started using it, my skin was really great, and so I thought that this was helping it, and then when it got bad, like this wasn't even adding anything to my skin, and then I found two new serums that I love and adore, and so I just, yeah, this is just not really worth it to me because of that. It just doesn't do anything. It's like a cute bottle and I love having Versed in my life, but I definitely think there's better serums out there, and yeah, thankfully it didn't like make me break out or anything. It just didn't improve my skin at all, and I do love trying drugstore products because it's just fun and it's nice to save a little bit of money, but when it comes to my skin, I'm happy to pay if it works and I found something a little bit better, so I'm going to definitely toss this. Okay, moving on to a cleanser. This is the Neutrogena Hydro Boost Hydrating Cleansing Gel, and I was really excited about this because I love their hydrating gel moisturizer. I love that in the summer. It's such a great hydrating moisturizer, but this one you can see, I gave it a good try. I just, again, with the serum, I just didn't feel like it was doing anything no matter how many pumps I would put into my hand. I feel like it would never take off my makeup. I started using like a second cleanse. I guess I started using a first cleanse before this one just to see if that would maybe help, and even afterwards I just didn't feel like it was making my skin feel clean or even hydrated. So yeah, I don't love it. I thought I was gonna love it because of the hyaluronic acid. I am a big fan of hyaluronic acid in my skincare, but yeah, this one did nothing for me. I actually am still gonna keep this because I like to clean my makeup brushes and my beauty sponge with it. I don't, it's like so random, but I figure like it's not really doing anything and I don't really want to throw it away, so I'm just using it for that. But I feel like that just goes to show like it's very gentle, it's very mild, but I don't see a difference in my skin and I don't feel clean, so I'm repurposing it with something else. Okay, next step is a face mask, and this is the Formula 1006 Keep Your Cool Skin Calming Gel Mask. And this is another one that I've talked about before as I did like it initially, and I still have like a ton in there, and I've kept it under my cabinet just like thinking that I'll go back to it and I'll go back to it, and I never do. I never reach for it, so I figure I'll probably get rid of it now. It is like coconut and cucumber, and for some reason my skin just does not do well with cucumber. I've had like cucumber sprays, which just freak me out. I don't know. I just, my skin doesn't really like it. It always feels like very itchy and irritated. And it's the same thing with this gel. I feel like sometimes when I use it, it's fine. If I use it too often, I find that my skin really doesn't like that, and I take it off and I'm completely red everywhere, and not like a good red where you want it to like exfoliate, but just like an irritated red. So yeah, I'm gonna have to say no to this. I really wanted to love it, and I've tried it so many times, but I don't love it. I have a couple of hair care products that I really wanted to showcase because I feel like I try a lot of hair care products, and when it comes to like shampoo and conditioner, it's fun to try. Sometimes they're a miss and you don't really like them, but I never feel like I have like a ton to say about it. So I wanted to wait to get something that like I knew I didn't want to buy. Like, it was not good, not worth your money. And I finally found my two products. The first one here is this Pantene Cheat Day Dry Shampoo Foam. I initially got this because of the packaging. It's so cute. It just makes me, like, I just want to sit this on my counter. It's so pretty. I love the little kisses. I don't know. It's just, like, so, so pretty. But I don't know why I thought that this would be a good idea of, like, a dry shampoo in a foam. Ugh. So my hair is like already greasy and I just want to like zhuzh it up and get out the door, and when I put this in my hair, it would just like do exactly what you're probably thinking it would do. It would kind of just like clump up, dampen up. It was so bad. So I literally have like a full bottle of this because I tried it twice and I absolutely hated every single second of it. So definitely not worth it. Not a great idea. I don't really love like the foam on my dry hair. So yeah, I'm gonna have to say no to that. It was the worst. Next up is something that was sent to me in my influencer box, and this is the Aquas Prime Water Defense Pre-Wash. And I don't know if I just don't understand this. I mean, I understand the concept of a pre-wash, but I don't know if I'm just not letting it sit long enough, or I don't know. So essentially what you're supposed to do is put this in your dry hair and let it sit before you wash and condition your hair, just to help like break up any oils that are in your hair or products, dry shampoo, any of that, which I love that concept. I want to find something that I really love. Right now, I kind of do like my own version of this where I do like a detoxifying scrub on my scalp. And I think that that like really helps, and I love what it does to kind of really like get all that grittiness out of my hair before I wash it. But this, I just felt like did not do anything, and it smelled like apple cider vinegar, and it just made my hair feel really weird. It's a whole bottle of this, which I feel bad tossing out, but I just feel like it doesn't do anything. So I don't know, if you get influencer boxes and you've had this before, let me know, because I've heard great reviews on this brand specifically, but I don't like it. I think it's like a very like clean brand, I'm pretty sure. It doesn't say, but from what I can tell, it's supposed to be really good for your hair, but I didn't like it. So I have one body product, and this is just the L'Oreal Sublime, I can't say that word, Sublime Bronze Tinted Self Tanning Lotion. And I picked this up on a whim because I had like I had a Christmas party to go to, and I wanted to be nice and tan for it, as you would on like a date night, and I just want to be very glowy and like sparkly, I don't know. And yeah, I just did not like this. It's kind of like a liquid, I wish I could show you, but it's like a liquid, oh, there it is, a liquid consistency. And I tried to put it on with a brush, and I just found that it was kind of like wiggly and going everywhere, and it really wouldn't dry or set. And I really love using like a foam self-tanner. I think that those work the best. You can use them with a mitt. I feel like those ones really do not streak, whereas something like this, where it's very liquidy, it doesn't really set. It can kind of move around a lot, and I just had a lot of streaks, and I also felt like it was a little glittery, even though I wanted to be like very glowy and like shimmery. I didn't want to be like glittery, and it just has like a tiny bit of glitter that I didn't love. I'm gonna say no to this one. It's just very streaky and not, I wasn't a big fan. One of my last products is something that was so disappointing to me, but I'm actually happy that it didn't work out, because once I love something, like I love it hard and I didn't want to give it up. So this is the Simply Gum in the Natural Peppermint, and I picked this up at Harmon's. Again, it was right before a trip and I wanted to kind of stray away from all of the stuff that's in my gum and the sugar and the whatever. So I thought that this would work out, and it was nasty. Like, they're so gross. I can show you a little bit. First off, I don't like gum that's like, oh, I just dropped it. I'll have to find that later. I don't like gum that's like tiny. Like, I really love a strip. I like a big strip of gum. And so it's just this tiny little, it looks like kind of rabbit food, and it tastes nothing like peppermint. And I just feel like the flavor doesn't last long. It's not worth it. I would rather take a little bit of chemical in my gum and just keep it pushing and moving on. I did really love this one because in the back it comes with like these little papers that you can throw away your gum in. How cute is that? So I wish that they were just like, I don't know, come out with something a little bit better, because I hate it. But I also tried the grapefruit kind and it was horrible. So that is your feedback on this. I know that I shared this in my What's My Travel Bag and I was so looking forward to it, but yeah, it was not worth it. And I've already like picked up a Costco amount of gum, so I'm fine. But yeah, not a fan. And those are my top 10 do not buy products of this year. I feel like I'm always adding to that list. So let me know if you would like to see a video like this again in the future. I would love to do so. I'd also love to share some of my favorites. You guys can follow me on Instagram. I'm always sharing my favorite products in the moment, things that I'm eating, things I'm doing. It's a great place to connect with me over there. So I will have that linked down below. I hope that you enjoyed, and I will see you in my next one. Bye.